for the time. So I want to start to build all the sketches into fireworks. So in fireworks, we always deal with creatures. All these are the different things that I built. Let me zoom in. All these things are the different things that I created. So in fireworks, we can support multiple pages. Okay? Imagine if you are using this for other software, you need to create different file formats for different screens. But in fireworks, I do not need to. Okay? I can create everything in single one. So something like this. So in fireworks, I can also have master pages, which is templates, which means that I lock down every single screen to that. So right now, I have this thing that I brought in inside fireworks. Then I set it as a master page. So once I set it to the master page, all the rest of the pages will be linked up to it. You see that? Because I link it all everything to the master page. Okay, now I want to do something to the master page. Okay, in fireworks I built an extension for all the iPhone symbols so I can reduce them over many times because I know my main workflow is to prototype mobile devices. So it can be Android or iPad, iPhones. So let's say I want to bring in phone status. Okay, there I have. Once I bring in, everything will have that symbol because it is part of the master page. So I can start to build all the various pages. Next, I want to talk about better drawing in fireworks. Okay, here I recreated the logo of USA Today all in vectors. So when you are doing all the mobile design, right, you will be submitting to all the Android App Store or Apple App Store. Okay? So I can see that everything inside here is all better. I can resize every time I want, be it for iPad, Android or iPhone. Because you need to have the flexibility to scale all your images. Take for example for iPhone. Yeah, I want you to pay attention to the pages section. Okay, let me reduce the thumbnails to none. So once I reduce the thumbnails to none, I have an outline. This is the outline that we use to build iPhones. You see, I need to build screen design for iPhone 4, screen design for iPhone, iPad, portrait, iPad landscape, and all the different icons. You see that? So if you just design in one way and scale later, you found that you need to resize it and everything is gone. So you need to produce everything in better format. You get it? So now I'm going to go back to here. Okay, for the App Store iTunes page, you need a very large icon. So I can actually resize it to 512. Okay, for example, this 512. Okay, I just take the entire thing. Come inside here. Okay, just conform it to 512. Something like that. And I just need to hit to canvas. So everything inside fireworks will do all the things for you because everything is vector based. Fireworks is a vector based and a bitmap pixel software. And get it? Okay. So let's say now I have this thing. I can just bring it into here. And this is my first screen of my splash page. Can you get the picture? Okay, right now I'm also going to build the icons. Okay, this is the splash page I'm completed. So now I build the icons. Okay, all the icons here is using symbols. Okay, I just group everything. You see that on the properties where it says symbols, you can group everything as the symbols. Why I group it as symbols? Because I will need to reuse it again. That's the default state and there's a over state. So when I do this, I don't need to recreate, I don't need to care less about all these things. So I can do a group. Okay, later I'll show you why I need to do this. Okay, I just do a group. So once I do a group, I can shift it around. I can even use the sub select tool to continue to do the individual stuff. Okay? Okay? So now I go to copy, paste, okay? So not be afraid of all these things, okay? It's just the underlying stuff. Okay, so I just need to make sure that everything is in perfect condition. Okay. Oh, sorry, I think I copied the background. I should be copying this. You see that everything that I do in Fireworks is so much easy because in Fireworks, in compared to other software in the market, Fireworks is just like iPhone, it's touch screen. Whatever things I click will be selected. I don't need to care about the layers. But in other software, you need to make sure your layers picking convention is very good. Then you need to select. So inside here, I do a copy and paste again. Now, next, I want to go into the weather. So this weather, I have some of the stuff inside here with the icon. So let's say I'm inside the weather, I want to do the mouse over. In actual fact, I actually prepare the symbol for the mouse over. So I just click on the symbol. Okay, I do the stop symbol. I know that I have an icon called weather over. Okay, weather over. Done. That's it. Okay, then I can continue to bring into the pictures. Okay, so far. So now I'm going to solve the pictures. I'm going to solve the symbol. And voila. So I have this. So inside Fireworks, I can build various screen design of a particular screen. Because iPhone screen don't change. It's always fixed, so I can do many multiple variations. For example, use text. So now I want to simulate how the inside page looks like if I keep one of the channels here. Okay, this is a placeholder in Fireworks. So whenever I rescue something, it will tell me what is the dimension of this coming. So now I'm doing the second step. So the second step, I'm going to build what if people speak of the coming, they will see the actual photo. So I actually have this photo inside Photoshop, which I want to open up and show you. Okay, this is a photo in PSD which I did using Photoshop. Okay, there's adjustment layers, all kinds, masking, etc. I want to bring this thing into Fireworks. Okay, so I just do an import. Okay, let me find the PSD. This is the exact same photo. Okay, just include background layer. Okay. Then I have this import sign. So now I'm going to import the PSD into Fireworks. Hold on. Now I have my PSD imported into Fireworks. Some places are not very well touch up. I can continue to touch up in Fireworks. Okay, the same rules apply. Let me see. I need a little bit of blur. Just need to touch up all these things that you want. Okay, this is just a simulation of how you can do Photoshopping in Fireworks. Okay, so I can have text. Okay, one good thing that I like to play with text in Fireworks in other software is I can dynamic speech them without going to even bother to type 12 pixel, 40 pixel. Everything is screen based. So I can actually increase or do whatever things I want. Okay, lastly, I have this snapshot. So here is a snapshot of fashion voting, which I need a button. So I'll go back to my common library. Okay, drag out the iPhone symbol. This time I look for a button. Let's see. Ah, like that. Okay, so now I have the iPhone default black button. Okay, then I don't like the word button. Right. Okay. So now I have a button, the name called vote. Okay, I don't need to type or separate any of the buttons together because this is a rich symbol. I can identify what text I want to put for all these iPhone device. Okay? So this is basically it of how you can do your book cutting. So if this is a document with multiple pages, it will help you to go through which of the pages you want to pop. So in this example, I only have one. So I just open. Again, insert directly over here, but I don't want, so I want to import as a new page. So I go to import. Open that. I choose insert after current page. You see that? So once I insert the current page, you will not insert on this page. Okay, I click open. Okay, now you add a new page called iPhone app. If you see from here, previously I was saying all the screen design is based on the master page, but it also allows you to import other pages inside your iPhone application. Okay, one last thing before I end my stuff. Okay, here is a typical scene of the various stuff that I built for your projects. So I want to simulate how it looks like, so I create lots of hotspots from one screen to join to the other screens. So I can go to commands. Okay, I can go to iPhone, like preview and package. So this preview and package is just like iPhone simulator. I can prepare all my images and how it looks like inside my phone. So it can actually tell you how does the vertical screen looks like and use what page. Same for horizontal. So I click the link, preview. Okay, so now I have a simulator in iPhone based on the screen that I built. Okay, screen one is splash page, okay, lines, weather, photo, and stuff like that. Because I built in some interactivity, whatever things I click will based on the screen that I want you to go to. So I click, it goes to the lines. So I can play around with the icons, weather, features. Because previously I built the states where the thumbnail will go to the inside page. So once I click inside, you go to the inside page. Okay. I do not need to actually export it as a web page and log in the IE browser or Firefox. Because I want more entirely workflow in Firefox. Okay. So this is the best workflow for anyone who wants to do mobile photo detection. Okay. So same for snapshot. Okay. I can even do flipping, but I did not prepare the pages, so it looks like that. So if I tell you that the flipping of the other side is using one page, then you do that.